Hi, I'm Jim, W6LG, your ham radio Elmer here on YouTube. I have a 3-element Yagi on a rotating tower, and we'll take a look at that right after this. I have my tower in the backyard behind the house. It's a single-story residence with about a 12 and 12 pitch, I think. And during the daytime, I tend to keep the antenna down and run it up at night. And sometimes in the early morning, before everybody heads for school, I also will run it up. The point being, I have a motor on the tower, and I can remote control it. And I'll show you how that works and what I set up in a video that I filmed a few days ago. Part of the video is during the daytime, part at night. And I'll have a block diagram of the device I use to run it up and down. It's in a metal box next to the tower. There's two pulse width modulation devices, a power supply, a solenoid, a relay, and a remote control. All of that was off-the-shelf stuff, mostly purchased from Amazon. I may have gotten a winch from Harbor Freight. Anyway. Have a look at the video, see what you think. If you have some questions about how I did it, please post them below. If you haven't subscribed, please do that if you can, and give me a thumbs up. So here we go with the video I shot with the antenna during the daytime and during the nighttime. Here we go. So here's my Yagi, and it's homebrew, 3 elements on an 18-foot boom. In meters, it's about 5.5 meters long. From the driven element, which is in the middle and has a hairpin match across it, the distance from the driven element to the reflector is 6 feet. From the driven element to the director is 12 feet. And I did that on purpose. I wanted to get as much gain out of the antenna as I could. The antenna is going up at its regular rate, and I'm going to speed that up here in just a second. Reason for that slow speed is it makes less noise and it doesn't attract as much attention. So the rate at which it goes up is slow and the rate at which it goes down is slow. Now I'm going to speed that up to 6 times its normal speed just for purposes of the video. The top section, there's 2 sections of the tower. The bottom section is round, top section is square. There are rollers at the top of the bottom section so that it stays centered as it goes up and down. I've got a cable on it. The cable has a lock. The cable keeps me from raising the antenna beyond 30 feet in height. There is a city restriction that the antenna be no higher than 30 feet, which I don't like, but that's the way it is, and I don't think the city is going to change their mind. It has no impact on anybody. So I've sped it up, as you can see going down now. It's a lot faster. I'm going to show you a block diagram next of the parts and pieces that are in a box adjacent to the tower, because it takes a bit of electronics to control the movement of the tower up and down. The power supply is in the upper right corner. There's a solenoid to handle the switching currents. That in turn is connected to a relay. The relay picks the direction, so whether it's going up or going down, it picks one of 2 speed controls that are attached to the motor. The reason for the 2 speed controls is it takes less voltage going down for the same speed. So to compensate for the up and down speeds, I've got the 2 speed controls, which are just off the shelf from Amazon. And again, I've sped this up a lot so you can see what it looks like going up and going down. And at night, I can run the antenna up and get on the air. And during the daytime, I tend to keep it down. And most of the time on 20 meters, I'm not chasing DX during the day, usually early in the morning and late at night. So that's my homebrew 3-element Yagi on an 18-foot boom. And it goes up to about 30 feet in height.